everybody. It's good to be here today. Good to be with some young brothers today. We're talking about community service, part of the Greatest Minds, mentor, volunteer, participate. Very proud to be here. My name is Chip Greenwich. I'm the president of the Greatest Minds Network. And today we're about to do some service in Atlanta. And that's what we're about, doing service and so forth. So we have a bunch of snack treats and so forth for young people and for also some of the people less fortunate than us out there, just to give out. And this is what we do, and the whole thing about giving to other people, Black Lives Matter and all this stuff is about us as people of color also looking out for each other as well. So that's one of the major things about that today. So I'm glad to be here with the Greatest Minds Network, and just want to introduce these young men. Please, go for it.
All right, so I'm Wickinson Demetri. I'm a junior. I'm gonna graduate probably 2022. I'm studying criminal justice right now.
My name is Justin Perry, class 2022, major in dental hygiene and exercise science.
And again, one thing about the Greatest Minds is about race, socioeconomic class, and talking about gender identity, all those different issues coming together, but also how we build our communities through mentoring, volunteering, and participating. So first question for you, why is it important today? I know we talked about this. Why is it important for you today to be out there helping other people about, you know, giving out resources and stuff, especially to people without such means, or the homeless population? What's been your drive to do that? You called me up and you said, let's do this. And I was very proud. And so, you know, today, but we'll be doing several days as we get into the fall semester. But tell me, what was your thought about it?
You know, so my whole drive is fitness and wellness, just living a good life. So me trying to bring other people into that, myself, I got to set an example and be like, it's not just about working out. It's about just being a great person, helping others. Because that's what I want to do. I want to influence people. I want to be that guy that everybody's like, damn, I want to be like that. I want to do this. I want to go try and help other people. I want to get fit. Because that's what I'm all about. That's what I'm trying to market myself as. Excellent. So that's what I do.
What's your thought on this, brother?
For me, like, I've always been, like, even since I was, like, young, I've always been, like, big on, like, social justice. Like, I've always been big into politics and everything like that. And one of my biggest things is, like, be about what you talk about, because a lot of people will say all this stuff, like, they'll post, you know, a hashtag, whatever, but then when it comes down to doing the groundwork and the nitty-gritty, they're not about it, they don't do it, they don't support the movement. They don't support the movement, and supporting a movement is more than just reposting, so that's just what I'm trying to do.
It's more than them clicks.
And like what he was saying, I'm trying to be someone that the younger me and younger kids will be like, okay, not like an idol, per se, like a Kobe or a LeBron, but just be like, hey, yo, like, he's like someone like him. Like, if I meet your mom or your dad or whoever, they'll be like, yeah, he's a good dude, you know, stick with him, follow what he's doing, and yeah, just being better than we were yesterday.
Excellent. And can you give us an introduction of who you are?
Okay, well, yeah, like I said, my name is Justin Perry. You can follow me on Instagram at prez.jp, P-R-E-S.jp, for all types of stuff like that.
Oh, yeah, follow me on the gram at WickTheGo. You know the vibes, guys.
Yes, and what year are you in school?
Yeah, class of 2022, major. School, GGC, major dental hygiene and exercise science. Excellent. Gym head too, so you know, you listen to this now.
Every day.
So, gotta get to it.
Who are your role models? Think about your own life.
Role models?
Yeah, yeah. No family members, though. I just want you to think about people non-family that are your role models.
Kobe Bryant.
Kobe Bryant, why?
Kobe Bryant is just, his work ethic. That's why he's just that guy. He just works hard every day. Doesn't stop, doesn't quit. And Kobe is giving back a lot. Like, he's always in different types of groups. And he's just a great leader to me. Kobe just demands, like, when he comes into the room, like, he demands attention. Like, I love this. That's why I strive to be like him.
So. Excellent. Rest in peace, man.
Rest in peace, Kobe.
Rest in power, too. Yourself?
Yeah, for me, I would say Kobe Bryant or Mike Tyson especially, because one thing about them, like you said, the work ethic, but more like the mentality, how they approach it, more so than the work itself, because they're obsessed with what they're doing, and they put their whole soul and their whole being into what they're doing. So the fact that someone can actually dedicate themselves fully to that is just inspiring to me. So that's right.
The next thing, what do you guys are involved in just in the community? Have you guys involved in anything? You know what I mean? Think about something when you, what was your first exposure to doing community service? Do you guys remember something?
Yes.
Really young.
I used to do this thing for the United Ebony Society. I used to do run MLK events and volunteer and do different types of things with them. Like every year, I did it consecutively like for 4 years. So, yeah.
How about
yourself? It's like, I do like petitions, hand out petitions and stuff. Like around like voting time, you get people to go to the polls and everything like that. So it's something small, but it's a little something.
How important is to vote? this year. Nope.
It's important to vote every year.
Important. Do not only vote when there's a president. You need to vote in between elections. Your judges, your city councilmen, your attorneys. You know, your chairman, board officers, and everything like that. In between, the voters in between for like Congress representatives and senators and House representatives is actually more important than the presidential, because like we saw with Obama, even when he became president, he wasn't able to do shit because he didn't have the support of congressmen and senators behind him. Same thing with Trump.
That's all right, go for it.
Oh, my bad. I mean, same thing with Trump. Like, he will be able to pass a lot of the stuff that he's been trying to that everybody would definitely hate, but because Republicans, even though there are a lot of Republicans, a majority of Republican power in the Senate, a lot of them don't like him. But if you replace him with someone like Mike Pence or whatever, the American political landscape would be way different right now. He would probably pass the majority of whatever legislation he wanted to. Just like how when Obama was president, right? He had every Democratic vote, but because all the Republicans said no, all his stuff, shut up. He wasn't able to do pretty much anything. So it's very important that you vote in between, not just every 4 years. But saying this to the black people, because we only like to vote for the president. You gotta vote in between. Because real change happens in the small part, the small offices, not just the big ones, the small ones. So pay attention, stay woke.
With the other than that?
No, I do not. Right. Not at this time.
And just one more thing about, what is the biggest issue that you believe that's facing African Americans in this country right now?
I'd say the biggest issue is us not working together. Yeah, exactly. We have a lack of unity. A lot of other communities, the Hispanic community, they stick together. The Jewish community, they stick together. Everybody works together. But the black community does not like to do that. As a whole, we don't do it.
People will be quicker to tear down a ship because they can't be the sailor, just because. It's like, just people need to be okay with just being a follower. And being a follower doesn't mean you're inept at something. It just means you recognize that someone else can be better suited at that moment in time to lead. You can still be a leader and still follow somebody. You know what I'm saying? But people don't realize that, especially in our community, you know, the whole culture and everything. It makes it seem like if you're not a head honcho, you're lagging and slacking or whatever. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So we just need to change that narrative as a whole. And it's okay to work together. It's okay to not be solo. Yeah. People are too obsessed with just being guided out of the mud by myself, guided out solo, dolo. Like, no, work together.
Work together.
If you have a shoulder to lean onto, use it, because it will help you. And that's how you build generational wealth. And just, you stop all the bullshit going on.
Good question. And the last question I have for you, both of you, is what is your prediction of 2021? Do you have any predictions that you want to see happen?
It's going
to
be a great year. I believe change is coming, for real. Because I know a lot of people with their Black Lives Matter movement, some people use that as a trend, but I truly believe 2021 will open some doors for a lot of people. I believe that there's going to be some change. A lot of these companies seem like they're going to change, so we'll see. We just got to keep pressing on and do what it do.
Personally, for 2021, I'm not too hopeful for 2021. However, what I'm hopeful for is that the 2026s, 2025s, that part of time, that's when I feel like we'll see a lot of change, because you have a lot of our youth, like in high schools and stuff like that, a lot of them are the ones, you know, making protests and getting involved and stuff like that. And especially like young black women, they're really, you know, grabbing the bull by the horns and getting shit done. So I feel like when they graduate and once they start, you know, into their career fields and positions of power and stuff like that, because they're killing it. So once they really start making shit shake, I feel like that's when we're going to start to see, in the black community especially, or really, really, we're going to see change start to happen. But I think not as soon as we think, but probably later down the line, 2026, 2025, for sure.
Excellent. All right. It's a pleasure to be here with you, young man.
Appreciate it.
You know, we're ready to hit these streets, man, to give out some of this service and be accountable.
Sure.
Very good to see you, everybody. Welcome to the Greatest Minds table, right here.
See those officers arrested.
Trade my 4x4 for GC3, ain't no more free to speak. I gave him chance and chance and chance again, I even told him please. I find it crazy the police to shoot you and know that you did, but still tell you to freeze. Fucked up, I seen what I seen. I guess that mean hold him down if he say he can't breathe. It's too many mothers just grieving, they killing us for no reason. Been going on for too long to get it even. Throw us in cages like dogs and hyenas. I went to court and they sent me to prison. My mama was crushed when they said I can't leave. First I was drunk, then I sobered up quick when I heard all that time that they gave to Talib. He got a life sentence plus.
We just some products of our environment. How the fuck they gon' blame us? You can't fight fire with fire, I know, but at least we can turn up the flames some. Every color person ain't dumb, and all whites not racist. I be judging by the mind and heart. I ain't really in the face.
I got some money.
Spend on some good.
Hey, put me on camera.
Spend on some good.
Spend on some good,
all
right? Well, I can sing,
good.
Too.
Yeah, sell food, sell food.
Spend on something important. Got you, my man.
So I just wanted to come out here and do some good, you know, just out of the kindness of my heart. No event, no big, you know, thing going on. I just wanted to do it. Sometimes you got to get back to the community. You know, I go to school around here. I see the same guys out here all the time. And, like, you know, most of the time, they ask for a couple dollars I can give out. But, you know, I want to do something different, something bigger. You feel me? Because, like, it hurts to see the same people out here. I want them to do better. I can't help everybody. I'm not at that stage in life where I can just, you know, bring everybody together, but any little thing counts, especially when you don't have anything. So that's why I try to come out here and do the best I can. Give a little snack, you never know, they might have not eaten in the past 24 hours. That little snack might do something. That $2 to get them a water, a pair of underwear, a shirt, something, you know? So I just want to do the best that I can. So that's what I can do for right now. I'm going to keep getting better as I grow. That's what we're going to do.
For me, like, it's always been something I've been, like, passionate about, something I've always, like, been about. And it's just being about what you talk about, you know. Nobody likes to see homeless people struggle. No one likes to see a mother and her baby, you know, on the side of the road. No clothes, no food, no anything like that. So just the fact that we're able, you know, just to give back and just do a little bit of good with what we can. You know, we're young, we can't do too much, but just doing what we can, and that's an important thing. So I think everybody should just do what you can and give back.
And it's very important, you know, as the older generation here, just to make sure that we support and come out here and make sure the young brothers are supported and all that. That's what Black Lives Matter is about. That's what Greatest Minds is about. That's what all this stuff is about. We all coming out here together. Each other's faces. Hey, bro. So proud to see you, man. So
face
good,
to face,
man.
I want to make some people smile. You feel me?
Face to face, love.
Black joy. Black excellence. That's
good
what
karma.
About.
Good
Black
energy.
Lives matter. You're
right. Black lives don't matter. All lives can matter.
Thank you. What up? Hey, right here. Walking, 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 walking. Walking, walking.